Many of you watching will be wondering whether this is an evidence-based approach, a very reasonable question. The good news is there's a pile of evidence for the low-carb approach, and it's growing really on almost a daily basis. But before I come to that, it's perhaps worthwhile remembering that before the drugs for type 2 diabetes, a low-carb approach was the accepted way to treat diabetes. There was nothing else. And so that was going on for decades and was perfectly accepted and exists in the medical textbooks around the 1920s and 30s. Coming back now to some of the evidence we've got now, I'm aware of well over 40, there may be 50 now, RCTs on this. There are meta-analyses as well. And these are going to be lumped together, and there'll be a link appears below the video so that you can access this evidence and have a look for yourself. What's really good news now is the UK guidelines for doctors particularly mention that we should be advising low glycemic index carbohydrates for our patients with type 2 diabetes. Thinking about that, there's only one way to interpret advice about low glycemic index sources of carbohydrate. There has to be a lower carb diet, really, and that exploring that is perfectly safe and I think reasonable. And that's what we'll be doing later on in the series. Just even as a basic approach, the idea of cutting sugar, which is how I would always begin with a low carb diet, cutting table sugar, I think is completely reasonable for somebody with obesity and type 2 diabetes and a very safe first step. And you can start with that if you're nervous, but I'd advise you have a look at the evidence and judge for yourself. But I think there's enough evidence for us to use this approach. So, speaking personally, it's interesting for me to look back over the last 5 years and think about how few problems I've actually had. The problems I've had have mainly been to do with the advantages of the low-carb approach. So yes, blood pressures have improved and people felt perhaps dizzy when they first stood up because they were already on pre-existing medication. I don't actually see that as a problem because, of course, I've cut the blood pressure medication. I've encouraged patients to have their own blood pressure machines so that I knew about that as a problem. Another group might be people who are on pre-existing drugs for diabetes, which I'm keen to cut if that's what the patient wants to do. Again, if they're measuring their blood sugar, I know about those problems. I've had a number of patients who started with muscle cramps. In fact, I get them personally because I'm a runner. Now, the muscle cramp thing generally means you need more salt. That's easily done. So I talk about that in advance so that patients are not surprised if they get muscle cramps. They go, oh yes, well, Dr. Unwin told me about that and I just need to have salt. So I mention that quite commonly. Sometimes constipation has been a slight problem, but really, given that I'm encouraging the patients to have a lot more green veg, I don't think that is something that's a great worry. I'm still surprised really by how few patients have a problem. And when we think internationally, there must be well over, I don't know, 500,000 people doing this at least. And what's interesting is under and beyond them are thousands of doctors doing this low carb approach. And that gives me confidence really, because it's growing all the time. I'm in personal contact with 250 doctors using the approach in the UK alone, and that number is growing day by day.